everyone. Thank you so much for pressing play. I'm in the middle of editing a marriage series that I'm super excited to post. So I pray that it's such a blessing. And I was actually going to post one of the videos today, but I said, you know what? No, I need to share this first. It's just something that's been on my heart, and it's so fresh on my heart that I said, you know what? I want to record this and I want to get this out because I pray that it blesses someone. Yesterday on my Instagram story, which I'm gonna read to you guys. If you don't follow me on Instagram, please follow me on Instagram. Lately, I've been posting a lot on my Instagram stories, and I love hearing your feedback, you guys. So keep messaging me. It's such a blessing. It blesses me. So I read this quote. Right now, I'm taking classes for my biblical counseling certificate. And so I read this quote, and it's by Ed Welch from a book called Depression, A Stubborn Darkness. I've never read the book, but I really love this quote. He says, contrary to what we might think, God says that strong faith can coexist with emotional highs, lows, and everything in between. It is a myth that faith is always smiling. That ending line, I'm like, wow. It is a myth that faith is always smiling. My thoughts were, I said, I love this. Sometimes as Christians, we think we are lacking faith if we're sad, and in order to have faith, we have to always smile. Not true. What good is smiling if it's not genuine? How does it help to put on a mask? All it does is bury the true emotions deeper inside. True growth comes from working through those emotions. It's okay to be sad. It's okay not to have all the answers. Seek after the one who does. Cry out to God for understanding. Open up and seek counsel from people you trust who can pray for you, love on you, and encourage you in God's word. And then in parentheses, I put, expressing sadness isn't weakness. It's actually harder to share true emotions than it is to throw on a smile. Because if you think about it, anybody can throw on a smile, right? But if it's not genuine, then what good is it gonna do? Sometimes we think, oh no, I don't wanna share this because I just don't wanna discourage someone else. And it's not true. I've been blessed when people have opened up and said, you know what, I've had a hard week. Can you pray for me? So simple. And I definitely encourage you to find people who you feel comfortable, who you trust, to open up. You know, other believers who can lead you back to God's word, who can love on you, who could cry with you, who could pray with you, right? So I thought about that. I thought about, am I called to always be happy? Is it wrong to be sad? The answer is no, right? And of course, I'm not condoning us to sit in self-pity and to always be moping around and not grateful for what God has done for us and is doing for us and seeing the blessings in our life. I'm not saying that. If you've seen my videos in the past, you know that I have a video called Being Grateful While Waiting, right? Of course, you know, we should look to the positive things in our life, but there's moments where we're sad, where sadness comes in, where grief comes in, and that's okay. We have to feel those emotions, right? I think sometimes we just want to throw on that fake smile because it's easy, right? It's easy not to talk about it. What I'm starting to realize, and I don't have all the answers, this just came on my heart this week, so I'm still working through the scripture, but thinking about it, I see how important it is to be honest, to share what we're going through, to work through those feelings, to cry if we have to cry. What a blessing it is to cry. Am I the only one? Or is it after we cry, we feel such relief sometimes, right? It's just like, oh, I needed to let that out. And I say that especially because if you're like me, it's easier for me to be happy than to feel sad. It's easier for me just in my personality. I don't cry as often as some women do, but I see how important it is, you guys, not to force ourselves to cry, obviously. I'm not saying cry right now, but I'm saying if you're sad, if you're going through something hard, it's not sinful to be sad. I feel like sometimes we think it's sinful to feel sadness, to feel pain, to not understand, God, why did this happen? I wanted to touch upon a few scriptures. So I started off, yes, we are called to rejoice, of course, right? Philippians 4:4 says, rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say rejoice. We're called to rejoice always, right? And then I quoted this one author that I found online. He said, the difference for a Christian is not the absence of sorrow, but rather the source of our comfort. It's not the absence of sorrow, but rather the source of our comfort, right? It's not that we will not feel sadness. It's that in that moment of sadness, are we leaning on God in that sadness, right? Are we seeking Him? And through that, He grows us. And it reminded me of Romans 5:3-4 that says, suffering produces endurance, and endurance produces character, and character produces hope, right? So that suffering that we may be going through, that grief that we may be feeling, working through that, right? Seeking counsel, praying, Lord, help me, searching the scriptures. When we're in the moment and we're going through it, it's beneficial. Don't just bury it. Don't just try to throw on a mask and say, fine, I'm fine, I'm fine. When really you're hurting. We're called to rejoice with those who rejoice and weep with those who weep. Why does the Bible tell us to weep with those who weep if it's wrong to cry, if it's wrong to feel sadness? And I say this just to encourage those who might be sad, who might be going through a trial, who might be confused. Why am I going through this? And feel like, okay, I can't feel this sadness. I can't cry. I need to stop crying because then I'm lacking faith. Going through those emotions, seeking God through that, being honest about that, He helps us, He grows us, right? Of course, again, I'm not saying sit around and dwell in self-pity, and you know, I'm not saying that, but it's okay to be sad, you guys. And then another quote, I don't know where I got it, but I loved it. It says, it's not that we rejoice instead of sorrow. We rejoice in the midst of sorrow. So I thought about that. I said, it's not that we rejoice instead of sorrow. It's not like sorrow comes and pain comes and sadness comes and then I'm just like, nope, I have to rejoice. I can't be sad. I can't cry. It's not that. It's that we rejoice in the midst of sorrow. And so I thought about that. I said, what does that mean? And I would love to read more into scripture. This is still fresh on my mind and on my heart. So I haven't done as much study as I would like to. But what I think about is even my situation where we had a miscarriage. And as soon as I found out that we had the miscarriage, I wasn't rejoicing. Whoa, yes, we had a miscarriage. No, I was sad. I was crying. I was confused. I was praying to the Lord, Lord, why? You know, why did you allow this to happen? And as I started to wrestle with that, as I started to seek the Lord, that's when my heart started to truly rejoice, right? Not rejoice in the miscarriage, but rejoice in the suffering, seeing that just like it says in Romans 5:3-4, suffering produces endurance, and endurance produces character, and character produces hope, right? Just seeing that and trusting, remembering the Lord is sovereign. He knows why. Maybe the baby was sick. Maybe who knows why, but He knows why this happened, and trusting in Him, right? Trusting in Him. Is it wrong to cry? No. Is it wrong to feel sad? No. Do you have to rush and put on a smile if you're not ready to? No. In John 11:33-35, it says, when Jesus saw her weeping and the Jews who had come with her also weeping, He was deeply moved in His spirit and greatly troubled. And He said, where have you laid Him? Talking about Lazarus. They said to Him, Lord, come and see. And in verse 35, it says, Jesus wept. How comforting is that? Jesus wept. And so I have some questions that I want to end with. If you're in the middle of grief, if you're in the middle of sadness, are you seeking counsel from people who can encourage you in God's word? Are you crying out to God for understanding? Are you opening up about your sadness with people who you trust, who will pray with you, who will love on you. And even sometimes you'd be surprised. When I went through the miscarriage, I opened up to my church. There was women who reached out who've been through the same thing, who I had no clue. And hearing them how they coped through it, how they felt was such a blessing. I remember just crying hearing these stories. Another thing that I want to emphasize, as Christians, sometimes we think we have to have all the answers. Sometimes we think we have to know the right scripture to share at the perfect time. Sometimes all we need to do is hug someone who's sad, who's suffering. Sometimes all we need to do is just be there. And so, as you can see, this is something definitely on my heart. So I pray that this video blesses someone. Thank you again for everybody who's been liking, subscribing, who's been sharing. Please continue. If you haven't yet, subscribe. And most importantly, if you know anyone who any of these videos would help, please, 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 please share it with them. So yeah, thank you so much for pressing play. Bye.